Hey there, Measure Geeks, Julian here, back with another video. Today I want to show you how you can create a Google Tag Manager server-side instance in order to deploy your tracking from your website through Google Tag Manager server-side. So if you're completely new to Google Tag Manager, you probably need to log in with your Google account. I trust that you know how to do that. And then you will land on a screen just like this one where you set up the account. Normally you have, for example, a company that you set this up for. Go ahead and put that into the account name. You can choose the country and to share the data with Google. And then you enter your container name. This can really be anything you want. But if you want to keep it clean and you only deploy this for one website, you could put in your website, for example, in this field as the domain. And this will help you to keep everything ordered later on. And then we get to the target platform, and here we're going to choose our server-side instance. So let's go ahead and click on server and create. Now there's some TOS that we need to read through and accept. And then we get to the overview screen. Now you can deploy Google Tag Manager server-side automatically through the Google Cloud Platform. And for that, you also need to have an account then. Or you can manually provision your tagging server. For that, you would need to have your own server ready to deploy Google Tag Manager server-side. Read through the user guide if you want to be doing that. We'll go with the automatically provision tag server instance right here. So I'm going to click on automatically detect. And then we need to choose our billing account. Now again, if you are not yet familiar with Google Cloud Platform, you can go over to cloud.google.com and you would need to sign up and also already put in a billing account in order to set up Google Tag Manager server-side. I have done this already for my email address, and that's why Google Tag Manager already recognizes this here. This is my number one billing account, which I'm going to attach to my server-side instance. So I'm going to select this billing account and it will create the server. This might take a while, so sit back and I'm going to fast forward. And here we go. We have created our server. We get our Google Cloud Platform project ID. This is where you can find it again in your Google Cloud Platform later on. And we get our default URL. This is the server that was now created and that we can send requests to in order to try out our Google Tag Manager server-side instance. Now I say try out because now this has created a sandbox for us where we can try out our implementation. If you want to take this live to your website, you will need to upgrade this to a production version, which will cost you more money and requires a billing account inside of the Google Cloud Platform, which we have already set up. So let's go ahead and take a look here. It kind of looks the same as Google Tag Manager with the big difference that there is a new button here called Clients. And we'll go into this in a little bit. So what we want to do now is see if our server is actually reachable. So I'm going to go back here and just copy this default URL. And then I'm going to go ahead and click on preview here. And that will put our server-side instance into a special mode, which kind of looks like our preview mode on the website. But now I'm going to go to my page here, put in our URL, and we see we get a 400 error. But inside of our server-side preview mode here, we see that there is a new entry. And this is a request that we just sent to this path, which was just a slash. We didn't return anything. And none of the clients have claimed this request. So what can we do with this now? Google Tag Manager server-side is kind of set up. We could go ahead and send data to our server-side instance instead of Google Analytics 4, and then relay our information to the actual Google Analytics endpoint. For that, obviously, we will need a website. So here's our trusted demo shop and our client that we already have installed on this demo shop. And if we want to send data to Google Analytics 4, we usually just go over here and install a Google Analytics configuration tag, which will send our data over to Google Analytics 4. We just need the measurement ID, figure it out. So inside of our Google Analytics 4, we go over to the admin section. We go over to our data streams. And here we have our demo shop with our measurement ID, which we are also going to put in to this field right here. And now we have an option here to send data to our server-side container. And here we need to enter the URL that we want to send this request to. And this request we want to send to this URL, which we have already tried out. So let's put that in here as well. Now let's attach our all pages trigger. and then also give this a name. This is our config tag for our page views. Let's save this, and it seems we need to have a no trailing slash here. So let's go ahead and save this. Okay, and we can click on preview. Connect our preview to our site. And now that data that should be sent off to Google Analytics 4 is being relayed and not sent to the Google Analytics endpoint, but to our new server container URL. And that should have already been received here inside of our new server-side instance. So we have a page view here. This is the information that was sent over. So we have an incoming request, and we have a client that actually already claimed this. This is a client that is there by default. So under clients here, we already have Google Analytics and Universal Analytics. So if the write request comes in, clients are there to claim that request and then pass that information into a write format so you can later use it in tags. So this has already worked, and the information that this client has parsed is now available to us as event data right here. So this is the data that has been parsed. There's more here, and we can use that data in our tags right now. What do we want to fire? Well, let's go ahead and simply take this information and send off a Google Analytics 4 tag. For that, we can go over to tags and choose our Google Analytics 4 tag. There are not many tag templates out there just yet. And we can override the request that is coming in. So we could change the measurement ID if we wanted to. We could change the event name. But for now, I'm actually going to leave all of this untapped because we just want to relay the request and see how the tagging actually works. As the trigger, we have our all pages trigger. That kind of is a quite open trigger. This is kind of like an all catch trigger. So we're going to go with this one just because we have one request coming through. But if you only want to fire something on certain requests that come in, you definitely need to play around with triggers as well. So let's give this a name. This is our Google Analytics 4. Still, this is the page view we're going to send over. Actually, it's not really just the page view. It would relay any requests that come through to the server-side instance. For that, we now, to try that out, we need to still go on to preview. That will open up our mode here again. And then on our client side, we still need to reload and send another request to our server-side instance, which then gets received. And this time, so we have here our Google Analytics 4 server-side instance. We have a tag that then fired as well. And this is then transferred to Google Analytics 4. Can see that all come through, hopefully, inside of our debug view as well. Here we go. We had a page view here that came in not from our website, but it was relayed through our server-side instance. So this is how you can set up a Google Tag Manager server-side instance. There's obviously much more that you can do with a Google Tag Manager server-side instance. We have, for example, a video on how you can send data to the Facebook conversion API via Google Tag Manager server-side. Two steps that I haven't covered, which might be useful for you to consider. One is to actually update your domains, which simply means that if you don't want to be using the appspot.com domain, which is the default, because you want to do truly first-party tracking, then you can change this default domain around inside of your Cloud Console configurations. I'm going to link up a help article on how to do this down below. The second thing to consider is to actually upgrading your container to be production ready. That would mean that you upgrade the instance of the cloud machine that this is running on to have enough capacity to handle more than your testing. And again, I'm going to link up a post down below on how to do this as well. Don't forget, even on the server-side instance, you still need to submit a version. So this goes live, and the server-side instance would be able to receive those requests and forward them on to Google Analytics 4. And obviously, you would also need to do the same on your client side as well. So this is how you can utilize Google Tag Manager server-side. We set it up and sent our first tag through with Google Tag Manager server-side. If this video helped you out, I'd love for you to hit that thumbs up button and also watch this video on a little bit more overview of how Google Tag Manager server-side works so you know what you're getting into. Now, my name is Julian. Till next time.